so good to me. God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me.
Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, because thou art been with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Thus, those have been the words that have been encouraging me. I know most of us have been going through tough times. Maybe some of us may not understand, but it has been tough to most of us. But again, we thank God, because God never leaves us alone. He gives us friends and a family to comfort us, even during times of trouble. This morning, I'm going to speak about the same God, and we'll see how great God is. I'll just request you give me 12 minutes. So I'll go beyond 1 o'clock, because it's already 1. If you give me 12 minutes, then I will summarize. Is it okay?
Yes, all right.
Okay, the title of my sermon is How Great Thou Art.
Amen.
How Great Thou Art. Let's pray. Father, as we open your word, may you teach us your will. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Among the books that encourage me in the journey of life is the book of Psalms and the book of Job. I don't know about you, but the book of Job, it has been so wonderful to me in different situations. And I like reading it and the book of Psalms. That is why I came across the verse that we just read in the book of Psalms 92 and verses 5. And the Bible says, Oh Lord, how great are thy works, and thy thoughts are very deep. When we happen to be in difficult situations, I know that the Lord of the valleys is still the Lord of the mountains.
Amen.
The Lord of good times is still the God of bad times. And his thoughts are very deep. And let's see how God's thoughts are very deep in the book of Job. If you can move with me to the book of Job. And we read chapter 36 of the book of Job. Job was going through tough times, but God sent some friends to comfort him, although some were encouraging and others sometimes could not understand the situation he was going through. But let's see what he writes about one of his friends, who is Elihu, in chapter 36 and verses 26. It says, Behold, God is great. Behold, God is great, and we know him not. If someone will ask you, do you know God? Most of us will say, yes, I know God. But even for these people who went through the experience, they will tell you, we know little about God. Most of the time we rejoice during good times, but when bad times come, we see like, why does this happen? There's always a question. But God is great. And he continued to write and saying, and we know him not, neither can the number of his years be searched out. I don't know somebody who knows how old God is. But it's not for us to search out and find out how old God is. In the book of Daniel, it tries to describe through our human understanding of gray hair and white hair, we can call it. But God is even older than that. But that's not the subject for today. But we are trying to see that God is great. And if you could see God is great, see now, the conversation goes on. But before that conversation, let's read chapter 37 of the same book and verses 5. What does it say? Someone can read from there, the book of Job, chapter 37 and verses 5. Thank you so much. I like the last part which says we cannot understand why things happen sometimes the way we expect for good things, but sometimes things don't happen the way we expect. But still God is great. And that is why we are here to get comfort through even songs. Now I will speak briefly about music. After we have learned that God is great. Now, if it's great, when we sing, why do we sing? Now, the question is, why do we have music? God is so marvelous. He's so great. Now, why do we have music? It's for what purpose? If I will ask us, why do we have music? Why do we sing songs? As we have been singing since morning and during this afternoon. In one of the books known as Patriarchs and Prophets, by Ellen G. White, it's written, music was made to serve a holy purpose, to lift the thoughts to that which is pure, noble, and elevating, and to awaken in the soul devotion and gratitude to God. Do we see a contrast? Who is great now? Is it God, great or man? You see, I have one friend at work, always, it's my good friend, he's from Jamaica, always talks about who is this guy who died some days ago. You know this singer from, yeah? We don't know. From Jamaica, there is a singer who people like listening to, talk always about. You sing?
A long time.
And there's another one too. I think we have heard about these people. But we don't know still about this. Yeah? But the point is, music, the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. It always comes to not our physical emotional expression, but from the heart. Yes, physically sometimes. And verses 15 tells us that we need to sing. I will just read the first part, the last part, which says, I will sing with the spirit, and I will sing with the understanding also. Two things that are very important here. The spirit and the understanding. Even when we sing the spiritual songs, it should be in the spirit and understanding. In other words, what is the message? Is to praise God. And that is what we have been doing. The purpose of songs is to praise God. And we find that in the book of Psalms 150 verses 1, which says, praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary, praise him in the firmament of his power. And verse 6 of the same chapter says, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord, praise ye the Lord. And this was new to me, that even the birds, even other creatures, they need, of course they praise God, but sometimes we don't understand. Like in our culture, where I come from, The animal that wakes us up in the morning is the donkey. I don't know someone, the donkey, it's the one which makes the sound the first in the morning before the rooster. The rooster will come around 5. But the donkey wakes up around 3:33 o'clock. And it makes a very strange sound. And for those who are farmers, those days used to have the bulls to take them to go and plow the land. They used to wake up around that time at night. Because the donkeys are praising God. So all creatures praise God, not only human beings. Secondly, songs are there to give thanks to the Lord. And we find there is so much God has done for us. We also give thanks to Him. We have an example in the book of Exodus, chapter 15, of Miriam leading the choir of Israel, praising God for His marvelous works that He had done. He was so great to divide the Red Sea, and they went through. And so they are praising God for His, what He is doing. Number three, songs are there to comfort us during times of trouble and sad moments in life. If there is one thing that comforts me, that you cannot miss in my car, is a song. If there is no song there, then I think there is something wrong with it. So always it must be on. Songs will be there. And thank you, Grace. I like, she also likes songs, and she gave me a gift and said, I like the songs in your car always. And we thank God for that, because they are there to comfort us and to give us the energy, even when we cannot study the Word of God, but we find comfort through them. And we find this in the book of Acts chapter 16, when Paul and Silas were imprisoned, not for something crime that they did, but because of the Word of God and because of the truth. And when Paul and Silas are in prison, what did they do? The Bible says that, and at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. At midnight, they were praising. There is no time that is not appropriate for songs. Every time is appropriate. Even if it's midnight, you can wake up and start singing. And that's what they did. I don't know that they slept, and then they woke up, but they started praising God and singing. And the people were listening through that, and the message was going to the people through the music. And that was my fourth point, which says, the purpose of songs is a soul-saving instrument. And we find this in Testimonies for the Church, volume 5, page 493, which says, the melody of song poured forth from men's hearts in clear, distinct utterance is one of God's instrumentalities in the work of saving souls. To me personally, it has been one of the things that have been moving me. And I know some of us, as I talked one day with Sister Claire, she told me that it's one thing that made her come to our church. When she had a choir singing, it attracted her very much, and she came in and got the message about Christ. So music is one way of evangelism. So as we sing, it blesses us spiritually, but at the same time, it also points others to Christ. And lastly, but notice, the theme of every song should be the science of salvation. Amen. It's to be the burden of every sermon. The theme of every song should be about Jesus Christ and Him crucified.
Amen. Amen.
And when Jesus comes again the second time, in the book of Revelation, it tells us, chapter 15, that the redeemed from the earth, they will sing the song of Moses and the song of the Lamb, even the 144,000, but also there was another great multitude, the song known as the song of victory, because they had gone through the time of trouble. They also had gone through time of persecution, but here they are redeemed through the grace of God, and they are praising God for the marvelous thing that He has done, keeping them through the hard time they had gone through. May we also be found in this group praising the Lord when He comes. That our singing may not just be end like today or on this earth, that it may prepare our hearts to be ready for Jesus' coming. May God bless us in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
What do we say to that?
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Cyprian, for those wonderful words of life that the Lord put in your mouth to share with us. And as we continue on throughout the day, it's my prayer that we will continue to sing and lift up our hearts to the Lord. And to continue, at this time, we want to acknowledge in our presence today our own beloved elder and his wife. Some 2 weeks ago, we got the news that our sister Danielle lost her dad, and so we just wanted to lift them up in prayer. They were not able to, we could not do that in their absence, but we are glad that they are here with us today. And we